launched.
You're clear to dock at docking port 1. The commander will be waiting for you in operations.
Mm. Oh, dock. To move on.
Commander Ikande wants to see you. Follow me.
Yeah, that's why I'm here.
I had a friend.
Now we can get in it when we want to. This individual is busy. Really had to show I could never found this by myself.
Excuse me.
Your excuse.
First mission in the books and no casualties. Good work.
Remember to turn in any evidence fragments you find.
Why hold prisoners aboard the Vigilance when you could send them directly to prison?
Two reasons. First, Commander Ikande is playing this operation extremely close to the vest. That means keeping prisoners under his own roof until this is resolved. Second, this is an undercover mission. For our safety and yours, we need to keep these prisoners out of the spotlight. I'll be here if you have any more questions.
I can only ask you one.
At ease, Soldier. We got the message from the Regana about Austin Rick. We had him dropped off at a separate port. Off the books. Suffice to say, he's got a lot to answer for.
I risked my cover to do it, so you better appreciate it, mister.
I do. I know it's a delicate tightrope, and it doesn't go unnoticed that you're risking your own life to walk it.
Every tightrope act needs a safety net. We appreciate the fact that you're behind us, Commander.
You're talking like you're one of them.
One more thing before we move on. For transparency's sake, you should know we were the ones that hired Ecliptic to attack Neva's ship.
What?
There was concern after what happened with the Regana that you might have trouble earning Neva's trust.
They killed me.
Coming to her rescue ensured that would not be a problem.
There's just one problem. They killed me like 5 or 6 times. I could have died out there. Ecliptic doesn't have a problem. Yeah. Yeah, I could have died out though.
You weren't Ecliptic's primary target.
They
besides,
were hitting me.
I had
me.
Every confidence you'd be able to handle this situation. It was either that, or Neva possibly denying you entry into the Crimson Fleet for coming back without killing Rick.
I did kill him. Them attacking had nothing to do with anything. Well, it does seem like I passed their initial test.
Then it worked. You're in. Sounds like everything is going as expected. Now it's time for the next phase of the mission.
Our intel on Searsha was correct.
Searsha.
After we received reports on your interaction with Adler Kemp, we picked up on your rendezvous with Neva Mora.
Alphas indicate she's second in command.
That smile.
So getting on a good side will ensure you get into the Crimson Fleet.
What do you know about Neva?
The woman has a record that could stretch across Seoul and back. She started young as one of Neon's street rats and worked her way up to second in command. She's a force to be reckoned with, so don't underestimate her.
Who's first in command? Well, just pay me so I can get out of here.
You'll get paid once I consider your report complete.
It is complete.
And we expect your reports to be thorough. Where the Crimson Fleet is concerned, no detail is inconsequential.
So what's next for you on Neva's agenda?
I can lie. I was told to meet Neva at the Key.
Where you'll meet Delgado, no doubt.
Delgado is the leader of the Crimson Fleet. I have a profile here with some information on his background. You'll want to know the individual cadences of every member of the fleet, but Delgado's most of all.
Agreed. The last thing we need is to infiltrate the fleet, only to be kicked out because we've underestimated one of their people.
I don't disagree, but it's important to know your enemy and the best way to defeat them. In any case, now that you're with the fleet, you'll be operating independently. We will shadow you eventually, but we'll need to maintain our distance for now, especially while you're on the key. This will also give us time to bolster our defenses, should we need to engage with the fleet in the future.
Sir, on that note, shall we begin implementing the upgrade to our shields?
Immediately, Lieutenant. Notify the engineers and relay the information to the crew.
Upgrade my shield.
I hope your entry into the fleet has overcome any doubts you may have had regarding your mission. It certainly increased my estimates on success. Keep up the good work. We'll expect further reports. Dismissed.
Yeah, dismissed. What? Why is he going back? So what do we have? Dossiers? Oops. Didn't mean to do that. There was more than that. Well, Adler Camp. Agency UC SysDev. Crimson Fleet Profile Adler Camp. Classified information. Age 45. Personality hot-headed, competent, seasoned. Profile. Adler is a Crimson Fleet captain operating out of Sidonia. His hot-headed nature means Adler is easily provoked, which has gotten him into numerous scrapes. Despite this flaw, Adler is a seasoned ship captain, and in most cases, he can use his battle prowess to escape sticky situations. Addendum. As more information on Crimson Fleet captains is gathered, additional profiles will be added to Commander Ikande's office terminal. Oh, I want to see his office terminal. Delgado. We don't even have a first name, just Delgado. Age 44, personality clever, shrewd, careful, calculating. Originally hailing from Aquila City, Delgado fell into crime at a young age, despite being born into wealth. His parents exiled him in hopes of correcting the behavior, yet this only served to increase his criminal behavior, culminating in the theft of a cargo ship, which he used to initiate himself into the Crimson Fleet. Delgado is a shrewd, clever leader who isn't prone to rash judgment. He keeps a tight rein on the Crimson Fleet, but he's given his pirates enough latitude to do what they do best. His own parents exiled him. He stole a cargo ship and joined Crimson Fleet. Neva Mora, age 32, short-fused, temperamental, intense, incendiary. Neva Mora was born and raised in Neon and orphaned at a young age. She spent most of her youth getting arrested for crimes ranging from simple assault to grand larceny, and was a frequent visitor at the SysDev prison. I wouldn't say visitor. At 22, she stowed away on a transport to Aquila City, was eventually recruited to the Crimson Fleet. As more information on Crimson Fleet captains is gathered, kind of office terminal. Oh, didn't mean to do that. Nope. Okay, so it falls under Crimson Fleet profile. This is under notes. I could have sworn there was more. That there were like four or five. Never mind then.
Things are progressing rather quickly. I'm sure the commander is pleased.
He's acting strange. You mentioned the Vigilance is upgrading its shielding? I want shielding.
That's right. It's something we've requested a while ago, in preparation for a future conflict with the fleet. Once we finalize everything and run a few tests, we'll have the defenses needed for a jump to the Crick system when the time comes.
Wish I could ask them for shielding. Why is it called the Crick system?
The system was originally called Alpha Ophiuchi until a flag was planted there by Jasper Cricks, the founder of the Crimson Fleet. Since it was crucial that space travelers avoided that system, navigators marked it as Cricks on star maps as a warning. They could have just as easily labeled it Crimson Fleet, so I'm guessing the pirates themselves were responsible for spreading their leader's name.
Probably.
Over the years, people forgot the system's original designation and started calling it the Crick system. It's been that way ever since.
Do you have any detailed information about the Crimson Fleet?
Sure. We have a database of profiles you can read, which should help you ingratiate yourself with the group.
I read them.
However, the profiles are a guide, not gospel. Use what you can, fill in the blanks, and play off that. I imagine when you're done, you'll be able to generate far more accurate profiles than what we have in our system.
Okay.
Good luck on the key.
You're a strange person.
We've been trying for years to get someone on the inside, and now we have it.
You fix yourself? I'd like to return the medical supplies I got from the Regana.
Thank you. I wasn't sure what you were planning to do with them, or if you still needed them for your cover. We'll make sure they get transported to their original destination.
Do I need it? I hope that's not a big issue. How critical is the cargo being delivered to New Homestead?
Extremely critical. It's unfortunate the Regana caught itself in the crossfire of Neva Mora's personal vendetta. Fortunately, your actions allowed the Regana to reach New Homestead with its cargo intact. And you even returned the extra supplies that were jettisoned. We'll make sure they find the right home.
Why doesn't the UC send a fleet to attack the key?
I've asked my superiors the same thing. But the Council is resistant to the notion that the Crimson Fleet is a serious threat.
Really?
They perceive the pirates as simple opportunists and thieves, willing to betray each other the moment a better offer arrives.
But they kill.
In actuality, I believe the fleet is a massive threat, one that's growing more and more organized as the years pass.
They kill citizens. What's the primary directive of Systev?
Our directive is simple. We are tasked with the eradication of space piracy in the settled systems. As the chief source of pirate activity, the Crimson Fleet is our primary target.
Okay.
Best of luck. You are headed into a snake pit. Be sure to watch your step.
So where's this monitor? Is that it? This is the monitor? Let me just save in case crashing. Phobos. System, Sol. Orbital Phobos, type asteroid, temperature cold. The Vigilance is scheduled to be in the Sol system for an extended period to focus on technical upgrades and mission planning. Mast has been notified of their position. Ship information. UC Vigilance Division is UC Systev, Commanding Officer, Commander Kibwe Ikande, First Officer, Lieutenant Jillian Toff, Brig Officer, Armin Petrosian. Well, where's Ikande's? She said I could reference. Sorry about that. She said I could reference a
condo. I had a wager going over whether the fleet would let you in or leave you for dead. And, unless you're a zombie, I owe the ops team lunch.
Who the hell said that?
Ooh, really? Was it a choking noise or more of a rumble? Maybe it was both.
Sound a little too excited. Commander Ikande is the heart and soul of UC System. I'd follow him to the ends of the galaxy.
Command station. What's it say? Neva Mora will meet me at the key, the Crimson Fleet's headquarters in the Crick system. How far away is the key?
We should team up for the next mission.
Let me just look around.
Vigilance is a state-of-the-art warship. Anyone that gets on the wrong end of her guns is gonna have a bad time.
Oh, this is his. Have I even been in here? Maybe. Oh, combat tech catalog. Further increases the range and authority of combat tech weapons. So I don't know if I have any of those. I can take that? Huh. Sysdev crew uniform. Alright, let's take a look on his. I got books that are not real. Pirate operations. Reports of pirate activity continue to plague the settled systems. While the mission board supplies us with intel, the fleet often changes its targets to keep us guessing. According to Toph's report, there are three types of operations the fleet uses to fill its coffers. One, piracy. Two, smuggling. Three, theft. Yeah, I can count. They have honed these operations under their current leadership and would do well to study their tactics so that we can better protect the settled systems. Crimson Fleet Tactics. There is an old saying that to fight the enemy, one must know the enemy. The aphorism, while trite, still holds true today. Like many disorganized groups, the Crimson Fleet uses guerrilla tactics. They utilize the element of surprise to their advantage, grav jumping and quickly striking their targets before fleeing the scene. Can I grav jump in the middle of a fight? I don't think I could. These are not revelatory tactics. Throughout history, ambush, deception, sabotage, and espionage have been the tools smaller groups employed to outmaneuver larger naval forces. Sysdev was formed in order to fight this foe in a non-traditional sense. It is up to the leadership to find creative ways to do that without sacrificing the principles we hold dear. Personal documents. State of the Vigilance. After speaking with Commander Natara, Lieutenant Toft has assured me that Project Svalin has been fully tested with the engineers at SY-920 and approved by MAST. If everything goes according to plan, we will begin implementation immediately. When the time comes, this upgrade will be essential for what we have planned. Huh. Wonder what that's all about. What is Project Svalin? The Crimson Fleet Threat. It's no secret that we have trouble explaining to the officials at MAST the urgency of the Crimson Fleet menace. Despite the fact that they are a disorganized band of pirates, they must be treated as a criminal organization that poses a threat to the safety of the settled systems. Unfortunately, without detail on the inner workings of the Crimson Fleet, much of this is speculation. We need someone on the inside to help us fill in the blanks. This is why I've requested the records of every prisoner detained by the United Colonies. Surely there is a candidate among them who will suit our needs. I guess they couldn't find anyone, so they just grabbed me before I even became a prisoner. Resolve and purpose. There are years where nothing happens, and years that can define a life. I was 16 when I first took to the skies, 17 when it all came crashing down. It began with the ship. Earlier that year, my father had salvaged a wreck from the war, a B-class Deimos fighter from an abandoned star yard. It was old, outdated, and, to put it bluntly, a piece of junk. The controls were shaky, the plating was rusted, and the engine coughed like it had a bad lung. But none of that mattered to me. I was hooked from the very first grav jump. You see, up until that point, I had often struggled to focus. Nothing I did had any long-term appeal. That all changed the moment I took that Deimos junker out to the space lanes. For the first time in my life, I could see a life for me beyond the present. This ship, for all of its loose wires, dents, and pockmarks, gave me purpose. Something I could devote my life to. 3 months later, I was an escort for my father's freighter. 10 months later, we were attacked by the Crimson Fleet. Most days, I think about my father, the kind, gentle man who raised me. I think about how much poorer this galaxy is without his laughter soaring through its membrane. And other times, my thoughts turn to his son, the boy with star-bright eyes, and the future he lost. When I am confronted by this boy, my resolve begins to wane. I want him to forgive me for the man I've become, one consumed by hate and vengeance. I stand wordless as he tugs at the corners of my jacket, tears flowing down his cheeks, begging me to let my anger go. And in that moment, every part of me wants to embrace him and tell him exactly what he needs to hear. I want to tell him I will drop this accursed chase and give his future the chance it deserves. But instead, I turn away. I leave him crying, alone in the void of space. But what he does not realize is that I am doing this for him. I fight the Crimson Fleet for all the fathers and futures lost to a world that never should have been. And when I think of them, my resolve returns, and I have purpose once more. Alright, so he definitely has a personal stake in this. Interesting. I wonder if he'd say anything about that, because we didn't have that option.
Heard the Regana made it to port with zero casualties.
This is just the beginning. But it's an important first step.
You tell me, please, why are you so determined to destroy the Crimson Fleet?
They're a menace to civilized society. They attack supply ships, terrorize systems, and kill innocents all under a banner of greed.
Be specific.
It's not just that. I strongly believe that the UC has a duty to destroy the Crimson Fleet. Mm. After all, it was our fault that the Crimson Fleet was unleashed upon the settled systems in the first place.
Alright, he's not telling us about his personal stake. That's okay, though. Oh, how is the UC responsible for the origin of the Crimson Fleet? That's an interesting question. Yeah, I didn't know that.
I'm not at liberty to explain the origin of the Crimson Fleet right now.
What?
But suffice to say, it's a massive embarrassment to the UC. All I can tell you is that the key and the planet that it's orbiting once belonged to the United Colonies, and they were lost to those pirates. The Crimson Fleet is a product of our negligence, and I aim to rectify that mistake.
So the key is their ship or space station, I guess? Because it said it's orbiting a planet. I thought the key was, like, the system or the planet or just... I don't know what it was. Alright.
Report back when you're done.
Mm-hmm.
We don't have a full map of the fleet's roster. The members changed.
Get this crate into space.
Talk about my ship like that. I know I was ready to completely sell it and get a new one. So how far away is this system? All the way over here. So, right. I remember reading that we can only jump 30 light years at a time. Now let's set course for Narian Valo or something. Jump. Power up, man. I need to take away from lasers. I gotta come up with a different scheme. Hold up. Hold up. Nope. Okay, I didn't mean to do that.
Do you actually think you stand a chance against the entire system?
Yeah. I gotta stop clicking the mouse, because that fires. Okay. For real this time. Actual reality. Undocking. Not hitting or shooting the ship. Okay, so we need to take away from lasers so we can add to grav drive. Okay, so now only the second time I've done this. Oh, by Bernard Star. I think I've heard about that, like, in real life. Bernard Star System. Curious what's in this system. It's just called Frost. Extreme environment. Oh, it's got all of one. Hostile activity over there. Okay, so now we can jump to Narian. Wait. Oh, we were still heading to Narian. Valo is. Wait. Right, the red means we can't go. We can only go as far as Cheyenne. We can't just travel from Narian to Cheyenne. I mean, we can. I can go to Lunara or Cheyenne. Three, two, one, mark.
Welcome to the Freestar Collective. Please maintain your current course while we scan your ship.
I'm just passing through. Going on here. We got planets called Skink and Buren, Washaki, Montara, Montara Luna, some kind of Wellish. Oh, there's a whole bunch of moons for that one. There's a Trident Luxury Line Star Yard. Huh. Very interesting. We can't even get the Crix from here. We have to go to Carl Sagan. not that either. Okay, we should be able to go to where we want to go. Crix. Load, mod, spool, and calc. The key, huh? Until now, mister.
Captain on deck.
You said the tank was 10K, but it was
said captain on deck when we're here. Got 4K.
If you're stealing from me, you bet your ass it's your problem.
You kidding me? Way to make a mess in front of my new book.
Hey, steal from me and get caught. Better off dead.
Sounds like you did the fleet of faith. Now toss this body out of an airlock before it turns into a damn air freshener.
Sounds like it's in my ship. That's her. Well, you were standing here, it sounded like...
The hell took you so long? Forget how to grab jump or something?
I had to do it like 4 times. Why, did you miss me?
Please. It'd be one less sloppy rook whose mess I had to clean up.
You miss me.
The last thing I need is another Austin Rake getting cold feet. You want to leave the fleet? You pay the price. Not in credits, but in blood.
I can afford that price. Yeah, sorry I kept you waiting, I guess. I'm gonna kiss your butt a little.
Never apologize. Not if you want anyone in the fleet to respect you.
Okay.
And if they don't respect you, put a gun to their head and they'll get the message.
Okay.
But, all that aside, you made it. So now, you get to hear a nifty history lesson. Pencils ready? Good.
So in other words...
This floating scrap heap you're standing on is called the Keep. Used to be an old UC military star station, and now it's the fleet's base of operations. Might look a little beat up on the outside, but we keep it together.
Okay. So in other words, okay, if you say sorry to somebody... in the Red Fleet, they won't respect you anymore. If they don't respect you, shoot them. So what I'm gonna do is say sorry to people and then immediately kill them. It pisses you off. The Crimson Fleet took over an entire UC Star Station?
Sure did. Right out from under their noses. Way before you or I were born, though. We've held this station for a very long time. Don't worry. Delgado will tell you all about it.
Okay. I bet it really pisses the UC off that you're stationed here.
You think? And that's only part of it. I'll let Delgado fill you in on the whole story. He tells it better anyway. But I can give you the short version while we walk the station.
Story time? How delightful.
Anyway, I'll tell you all about the Keep. But it's better if I show you, too. Follow me.
All right. History time. So, the Keep is in orbit around Suvorov. That's the very same ice ball where the United Colonies built a supermax prison they call the Lock. The UC is so clever. Supermax prison, lock, key. Cute, huh?
I want to look around a little. Nice view, it says. I don't want to miss what she has to say, but I want to look around too.
Rook.
Thanks. Capture tray. This a take? I got Aurora.